Time and motion. Introduction. Time is indefinite, continued progress of existence and events in irreversible direction. It is a gap between two events. Measurement of time. It is difficult to imagine a house, an office, a school without a clock. A clock is a device to measure time. The standard unit of time is second. The other units being minutes, hours, day, and many other. A second is 1/86900 part of a mean solar day. 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute. 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. 24 hours is equal to 1 day. 365 days is equal to 1 year. 10 years is equal to 1 decade. 10 decades is equal to 1 century. 10 centuries is equal to 1 millennium. Periodic events. There are many events that are repeated after a regular interval of time. We call such events as periodic events and the intervals as periods. Coming of seasons, occurrence of day and night are examples of periodic events. Occurrence of your birthday every year is also an example of the same. The events that are not periodic are said to be non-periodic events. Coming of floods and earthquakes are non-periodic events. Sundial. It is one of the primitive devices used to measure time. It is based on the fact that the shadow of an object changes its length and position with the position of the sun. The sundial consists of a piece of metallic triangular plate fixed vertically on a circular board in such a way that the plate casts a shadow on the board and the position of the shadow can be used to calculate the time. Apart from the sundial, there are other primitive instruments of measuring time as well, like the candle clock, hourglass, water clock, and so on. The hourglass consisted of two rounded glass bulbs connected by a narrow neck of glass. The top bulb was filled with sand and a measured amount of sand particles streamed down from the top bulb into the bottom bulb, giving the time. Measurement of time using periodic motion. Motion that is repeated after a fixed interval of time is said to be periodic motion. Devices like watches and clocks are all based on periodic motion. One of the most well-known periodic motion is that of a simple pendulum. Our ancestors noticed that many events in nature repeat themselves after definite intervals of time. For example, they found that sun rises every day in the morning. The time between one sunrise and the next was called a day. Similarly, a month was measured from one new moon to the next. A year was fixed as the time taken by the earth to complete one revolution of the sun. Simple pendulum. A small mass suspended from a fixed point and allowed to swing freely under the influence of gravity is called a pendulum. A simple pendulum consists of a small metallic bob suspended from a rigid stand by a thread, as shown here. When the bob of the pendulum is released, after taking it slightly to one side, it hastens to move to and fro. This movement of bob from its mean position to extreme position is an example of periodic or oscillatory motion. The pendulum is said to have completed one oscillation when its bob starting from its mean position O moved to A to B and back to O. The pendulum also completes one oscillation when its bob moves from one extreme position A to the other extreme position B and comes back to A. The time taken by pendulum to complete one oscillation is called the time period. Some common terms related to a simple pendulum are as given here. Oscillation, one complete back and forth movement of a pendulum from mean position to extreme and back to mean position. Effective length, the length of the string from the point of contact to the center of bob. Amplitude, the distance between the mean and extreme position is called amplitude. Frequency, the number of complete oscillations made in 1 second is said to be the frequency. Time period, the time taken for one complete oscillation is said to be the time period. Factors affecting the time period of a pendulum. Time period does not depend on amplitude. Time period does not depend on the mass of the bob. Time period depends on the length of the string. Slow and fast motion. Motion of an object can be slow or fast. If an object covers a given distance in a short interval of time, it is said to be fast. If on the other hand, the time taken is more, the motion is said to be slow. Every day we seldom find objects moving with a constant speed over long distances. If the speed of an object moving along a straight line keeps changing, its motion is said to be non-uniform motion. On the other hand, an object moving along a straight line with a constant speed is said to be in uniform motion. In this case, the average speed is same as the actual speed. Speed, the speed of an object, is defined as the distance covered by a body in a unit time. Speed is equal to distance covered by a body by time taken into cover the distance. Unit of speed. Unit of speed is meter per second. It could also be expressed in other units like meter per minute or kilometer per hour. While writing units, care should be taken that the symbols of all units are written in singular. For example, we write 50 kilometer and not 50 kilometers or 5 centimeter, not 5 centimeters. Example, the distance between Rohan's house and his school is 1800 meter. He takes 30 minutes to reach the school. Find his speed. Solution, distance to be covered 1800 meters, time taken 30 minutes is equal to 30 into 60 second is equal to 1800 second. Speed is equal to distance upon time is equal to 1800 meter upon 1800 second is equal to 1 meter per second. Rohan travels at a speed of 1 meter per second. Uniform speed. A body is said to be moving with uniform speed if it covers equal distances in equal intervals of time. For example, a car moving on a highway. Variable speed. A body is said to be moving with variable speed if it covers unequal distances in equal intervals of time or equal distances in unequal intervals of time, however small the time interval may be. Example, a car moving on a busy market street. Two kinds of meters are fitted on the dashboard of a car. One of the meters has kilometer per hour written at one corner. This is known as speedometer, which records the speed. There is another meter called odometer, which measures the distance covered by the vehicle. Distance time graph. There are various ways of representing data graphically. They may be in the form of a bar graph or a pie chart. Using the graph given here, find the speed at position A at 1 second from start. Solution, speed is equal to distance upon time is equal to 3 meter per second. If the graph is a straight line extending from 0, it represents uniform motion. Observe the graph here and see that the body covers equal distance in equal intervals of time. These are the characteristics of uniform motion. Steps for plotting a distance time graph. On a graph paper, draw two perpendicular lines OX and OY. Represent time along X-axis and distance along Y-axis. Decide the scale. Example, 1 cm is equal to 5 seconds. 1 cm is equal to 1 kilometer. Mark the points on the axis. Make dotted lines along the time and distance and let them meet at a point. Repeat it for a few observations. Now, join all the points so formed in step 5. You now have a graph which is called the distance time.